Have you ever wondered what happens after the last Bitcoin is mined? Because here's the thing, there will only ever be 21 million Bitcoin, and we're already almost 95% of the way there. Right now, there are 450 new Bitcoin mined per day, but that number shrinks with every Bitcoin halving. And eventually, the number of Bitcoin mined per day will hit zero. So, what happens when all the Bitcoin hits circulation? Let's take a look at what's coming and why it's not the end, but the start of a new era. Today, there are just over 1 million Bitcoin left to be mined, and they're expected to run out by the year 2140. By then, all new Bitcoin creation will stop. No inflation, no more supply, just the full 21 million Bitcoin. But that doesn't mean miners disappear or the network shuts down. Instead, miners will earn revenue only from transaction fees, which are the small payments users include when they send Bitcoin. Right now, those fees only make up about 1.8% of miner revenue, but that percentage will grow fast. As Bitcoin adoption increases and more people use the network for payments, custody, and large settlements, the value of those fees could rise dramatically. Here's where things get interesting. Bitcoin supply is already limited, but it's even more scarce than most people think. An estimated 2 to 3 million Bitcoin are permanently lost, gone forever due to forgotten passwords, lost wallets, and early mistakes. So, instead of 21 million coins in circulation, it could be closer to 18 million. For a global financial asset, that's tiny. And when supply is fixed but demand keeps growing, basic economics kicks in. Scarcity creates value. That's one reason why institutional investors, public companies, and even governments are getting involved now. Therefore, things can get even more competitive. As block rewards disappear, Bitcoin shifts into its next phase, which could look something like 1. Miners secure the network using transaction fees. 2. Layer 2 solutions like the Lightning Network scale transactions to be faster and cheaper. 3. Long-term holders benefit from rising scarcity. 4. Global adoption drives more utility, not just speculation. It's not just about holding Bitcoin anymore. It's about how Bitcoin fits into the global economy, from reserve assets to cross-border payments. From inflation hedge to decentralized infrastructure, Bitcoin is evolving. So, what happens after the last Bitcoin is mined? It's not the end of mining, it's the end of issuance. Bitcoin won't need new supply to keep working. Its strength will come from demand, decentralization, and the people who continue to transact, build, and believe in what it represents. And the best part? You don't need to own a whole Bitcoin. You can start with whatever works for you, because time is running out on new supply. But we're still early in the bigger story. That's all for today's video. We hope you found it useful. And as always, make sure you're subscribed to our channel, because a huge 97% of you watching our videos aren't yet subscribed. So hit that notification bell so you don't miss more videos like this.